Welcome back to the show. How are you?
I'm great. Thanks.
Yeah.
Thanks so much.
I always like having you on the show because I just I like to talk about how different our lives are because we really have two totally different types of lives. Like you, you brought some photos with you today. This is a vacation that you went on?
This is a vacation I went on, yeah, a few
you
months ago.
You consider this vacation?
This is vacation, what okay. we're about to look
yeah,
at,
this
yes.
Is, yeah, so this is one thing here. Where did you go?
That is in...
Were you on Mars? When did you get to Mars? This is Elon Musk's house?
Close. Iceland. Woo! Yeah. And a lot of Icelanders here
yeah,
tonight.
The yeah. whole audience is from Iceland today. We do it every Friday, yeah.
Yeah, that's me mountain biking over moss-covered lava fields in Iceland.
What in the what is that? It's fantastic. Is that like a big fat tire bike?
Those are fat tire bikes, yeah.
And
yeah.
now, why would you ride on lava? Just, what?
I'll do anything for Eddie Bauer. No, Eddie Bauer sent me on this trip.
Is that right?
Yeah, they did, yeah. They sent me, they got me an adventure team with these guides. We were sleeping, basically I spent 6 days outside. Like sleeping in cabins where like 4 in the morning, you gotta go to the bathroom, yeah. you're marching through a blizzard into the middle of like, a valley in the middle of these mountains to do your business.
But what isn't Eddie Bauer just doing? why do you have to do it?
Let's I mean, this call is, him right now.
I know, exactly, right? Well, but that's pretty cool. So they just send you that and then, look, this, what is yeah. happening? I don't quite understand this.
There's a big glacier lagoon. It's Europe's largest glacier that is slowly like moving like honey down this mountainside and it creates this lagoon and you can go and kayak the lagoon. It's about a 5-mile kayak. It takes about 2.5 hours. But it's amazing.
Or you could...
you could
sit
take a motorboat.
Yeah. Sit in a hot tub and get wasted.
Or that. We could do vacation together.
I mean, I don't know, but we could, but I wouldn't be with you. I mean, I wouldn't be there. But what is this? This looks like claustrophobic to me.
That's ice climbing. So you kayak across the glacier lagoon, and you get to a black sand beach, you eat lunch, and then you go inside the glacier, which is kind of dangerous because it can collapse on you, and there are these melted holes. It looks like holes in like a rival, like a spaceship, and you get these ice picks, and you climb up about 100 feet up to the top of the glacier, look out, and then you go back down.
How fascinating is that? I mean, has that changed your life? I mean, have you? I wouldn't recover.
You would never come back from Iceland.
I think yeah. I would be a monk or something. I don't know. I go. That's my life. I live in the mountains.
Yeah, it completely changes things.
It does, right?
Yeah, because you come home and there's cars and there's smog and you
yeah,
just.
Yeah, you appreciate the little things. Yeah, but were you always an adventurous kid?
Yeah, I was. I belonged to the World Wildlife Federation when I was like a little kid. We're talking like 4 or 5 years old.
How did you get involved with that?
An adult signed me up, but yeah. I would go and I would.
I remember I ripped off a thing. It was like some thing on the side of the grocery store, like to join something.
Yeah.
And I was a kid. And I just thought it was free, a free phone number, really. I just ripped off the phone number. I was so psyched. I got a free thing. And I called and blah, blah, blah. And they called back and they called my mom. They go, I think your son called. He wants to join. He wants to be one of the daughters of the American Revolution. I was like, why not? I don't care.
Can we make this happen?
Yeah, I mean, I was like, can we do this? So what would you do in...
Well, I would have, you know, adults would take me to go hike and go to these big meetings once a year with other like-minded wilderness type people.
Wow.
And I was a little kid.
That's great.
And they would take me into the woods and I would find animal skulls. You know, like animals would eat another animal and they leave half the body there. And for whatever reason, I would take the skulls home and varnish them and keep them in containers in my closet.
You would have skulls, a box of varnished skulls in your closet?
Yeah.
Well, did that not scare, did freak you out?
No, that was like my thing. Like I liked weird stuff.
I would scream crying home and say, I just saw a skull in the forest. And I'd be so scared.
And I go, no, come on, let's stay here.
Yeah, really? Yeah. And now does your wife go on these trips as well?
No. No, she's not. We're very much opposites attracting, you know. Like if I want to talk about animal skulls or you know mountain biking and lava fields or whatever, she'll say things to me like, how about I go in my closet and I bring back a tray of my earrings and I talk to you about them for the next half an hour.
I got it. Yeah, no, all right, deal. A deal's a deal.
Yeah.
I love her.
Do you want to watch football with... Okay, forget it.
Yeah, exactly.
The earrings, the earrings. Yeah.
But you've been married to Sofia for 2 years now?
Yeah, a little over 2 years.
When did you know that... did you know that she was the one?
Yeah. Yeah!
That's great. I love you guys. Did you know that she was the one? Like, when did you know that?
I knew... Like, right away.
Really? As soon as you... Yeah.
Yeah, she was in New Orleans shooting this movie, so I was flying back and forth between, like, I was on a press tour. I was flying back and forth to date her. And she had just gotten out of this long relationship, and so the second time I went to go see her, I was in the airport, and I noticed that, like, People magazine had put me on the cover of the Bachelor issue. Right, like they, you know,
like
number one bachelor guy.
America's, yeah, hottest bachelor.
And so I was on the way to see her. I'm not anymore. And so I grabbed it off the shelf and I threw it in my bag and I went to go see her. And we got to talking and I said, look, I said, I know you just got out of this long-term relationship. And if you need to be single, then I understand. Like, I'm not going to like it, but I'll get over it. But I just need to know if that's what this is. I said, but before you answer.
Yeah, let me just show you something.
I want to show you something. And so I reached into my bag and I put down the magazine and I said, numero uno. And so She picked up the magazine, she opened it up, and I saw that she was flipping by my interview. And I said, what are you doing? She said, I'm seeing who else is on the list.
That's when you knew?
You're the one for me.
You're the one for me, yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Fantastic.
Yeah. On and on and on. I said, and it's on and on and on.